Hey, I'm Janek Gwizdala, and this is my new bass from Mayones Basses in Poland. It's their Jabba, I think, is the correct name of the model name. Five string, in which we all got together and put Aguilar. I think these are the vintage jazz bass pickups, and it also has an Aguilar preamp in it. And I haven't had the bass too long. And it's a great variant. You know, as you can tell from the wall behind me, I'm a great fan of having, you know, a variation in my gear, in my setup, things I can pick up and use and search for different colors and flavors with, and this fits very well into that category. I have a little delay on there. I'll give you the clean sound. And I'm just still getting used to the instrument and basically running down my my normal kind of finger strength and technique maintenance exercises, real simple diatonic stuff. Not the most interesting or musical thing to listen to as a listener goes, but in terms of getting around the instrument, getting used to a slightly wider string spacing, the fact that this bass currently has a low B. So everything's a fourth out from where I'm normally playing with the Federer, with the high C. I'm also going to experiment with changing the nut on this and putting a high C tuning on it, so it'll be E A D G C. But currently it's low B, which is fun. I haven't done this in quite a long time, having a low B on a fretted bass. So that's definitely fun. And just in terms of getting used to the instrument, I've just been trying to run a lot of those kind of ideas. Oops. And finding all those elements on the right hand in terms of where all those harmonics are and all those things I'm so used to with other instruments that I haven't played before, that I've been playing for a long time. It's been really interesting, you know, learning all that new stuff and learning all those new positions with the right hand. Very quickly, passive active switch is currently active. There's a passive tone control. So in passive mode, it kind of acts like, the way I think of it, as it acts like just the tone control on my P bass, for instance. This stacked pot, I think that's what they're called, stacked pots with two on top, bass and treble. As always, I tend to love setting my basses completely flat when I play them. So that's exactly what it is. Bass and treble just completely at 12 o'clock. Mid also at 12 o'clock. And I'm playing over the back pickup currently with the volume wound all the way up. If I do, so that give you an idea of the back pickup. That's a blend with the pickup selector for both, and then this is the front. And that's exactly what I like about trying new instruments like this, is getting to play with different sounds. And as soon as I demoed those three positions for you, the back pickup, the line I played was kind of, I felt it was stylistically right for that sound. Just kind of biting and kind of punchy. And then as soon as I blended, As soon as I blended the front pickup in as well and put it in the middle position, I was like, okay, already that doesn't feel right. And as soon as I went to the front pickup, I found that that's something I probably would never play in terms of music, musical content in a line. You know, I find myself moving my right hand towards the front pickup, playing a little more open, a kind of a Motown feeling and sound came into my head a little more when I heard that front pickup. So it's awesome, and that's kind of the reason I have so many different instruments, whether it's this brand new Mayones bass, whether it's a P bass or a jazz bass, basically any other bass that isn't my main axe that you guys mainly see me playing. That's the reason I have these basses, is to be challenged and to find new sounds. And that's, I didn't script that at all. And I got to be honest with you, I've only been playing this bass on the back pickup since I got it. So that's really the first time I've heard those sounds. And you see it live in front of you. I'm feeling it, you're seeing it, that it really changes the way I approach playing and changes the notes I want to play. I mean, I have an octave pedal down here in the chain. That would be a similar thing. If I play the octave pedal like that, and then it doesn't have the same conviction or the same message or the same weight to it. Maybe if I played it an octave down, it would sound a little more convincing without the octave on. But it's just that, it's using different sounds, different instruments, and different feelings I was going to say help shape my note selection, and it definitely does in a way. It makes me choose different notes, makes me play a little differently. It doesn't change who I am as a musician, which is awesome. I'm still the person with the same kind of melodic ideas. It just adds something a little to it, I think. I was messing around with a loop, and really, just in fact, I'll put that in again. Actually, I'm not digging that. And just hitting that C, gives you that feeling of quite a bit of power. It's something, if I was to use this bass on a gig, it's something I wouldn't want to be overusing. I wouldn't want to sit down here in these three or four notes all the time. But it is again just a really nice flavor. And you know, one of my first reactions is to try and do what I do, which is play melodically and play soloistically, and kind of go through my regular practice routine just as I would with any other bass, and see what I come up with, and see where this tuning and this bass and this setup, this action, and all these things combined, where that helps me go. That's different from where I've been before. So I notice, and if you know my playing at all, you'll notice similarities and melodic phrases that you heard me use a bunch of times before, and I noticed that those are coming out in my playing quite naturally. But there are certain things with the range and the fact that it's a fourth different from my Federa, for instance, that is pushing me to do some other things and actually to think a little bit more than I would like, because I'm just not comfortable with the instrument yet. But that's something that will just come with practice, and I'll get used to a low B tuning if I choose to keep it there for when I play this bass. I'm kind of psyched to try change the nut and try it with a high C as well. Maybe I'll do an update video for that when I try that out. But for now, yeah, I'll play out and give you a bit more audio of what this bass sounds like. Again, the passive tone control does work when it's in active mode, and I have that rolled all the way forward. Just gives me there's a little bit of brightness. Maybe you can hear it in the sound, as opposed to if this is with it rolled all the way forwards, and this is with it rolled all the way back. So you see it's a little bit darker when it's rolled all the way back. Maybe a blend in the middle. And there you go. Immediately, as soon as I blended it in the middle, it's more my sound. My sound isn't, what I go for, what I hear, isn't super bright. It's not that like kind of super, you know, Marcus Miller, for instance, I think has quite a bright sound, like new strings, especially with the slap sound, but just in general, I hear that as quite a bright sound. So that's definitely not something I hear for my own music or that I strive for. So a blend of the between the two, not too dark, not too bright, is probably what I'm looking for. Somewhere in the realm of like a dark, more like a jazz guitar sound, something like that. So I'll play out of this. This is the Mayones Jabba 5-string from the very good folks over at Mayones in Poland. I'm loving it, and it's, again, like I said before, it's a great variation for my kind of sound source, if you like. So yeah, I'm Janek Gwizdala, and let's play some more music. The top of 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 the top of